Welcome to PCB Heaven Tech Labs. Today I will explain how the stepper motors are made and how they operate. For this reason, I have made a 3D model of a stepper motor using a sophisticated software. Now, as you can see, this motor is fully functional. And instead of demonstrating the basic stepper motor, I chose to demonstrate a more complicated one. That is because if you understand how this one works, and believe me, it's easy, you will then understand easily how the other stepper motor types work. So, this is a hybrid two-phase stepper motor. To better understand this tutorial, you need to know how the simple brushed DC motors operate. I have a similar video that explains exactly how they operate. I suggest that if you don't know, you should follow the link that appears on the screen and see this video first. From now on, I will assume that you do know how the brushed motors operate. As usual, I will break the motor apart down to the shaft, and then I will start building up the motor from the beginning and explain each step I make. For me, this is the best method. So, here is the shaft of the motor. It's a simple rod made of steel, and there is actually nothing special to say about the shaft. So I will go on making the rotor of the motor. The stepper motors have the permanent magnets fixed on the rotor. So the next step is to put the permanent magnet. So this is the magnet. It's a simple cylindrical magnet, and you can see the north and south poles of the magnet. The blue region is the south pole and the red region is the north pole. So, on each pole there is a toothed disc made of iron. Both discs must have the same number of teeth, and this number of teeth will eventually determine the number of steps per revolution for the motor. Now I will install the first disc. This disc has a total of 24 teeth. The other disc will be installed on the other side of the magnet. And this is the final construction of the two discs and the permanent magnet. Now, as we know, because the discs are welded on a permanent magnet and because they are made of soft iron, each one will become an extension of the pole that it's welded on. So, the first disc is attached to the south pole, the blue region, and will also become a south pole. The other disc that is attached to the north pole, that is the red region, will also become a north pole. So, this is a permanent magnet complete with the two toothed discs attached to each side. What you have to notice here is how the teeth of the first disc are aligned with the teeth of the second disc. I will rotate the rotor to have a better look. And of course I will zoom the model. Okay. Now you can see how the discs are aligned together. The blue disc is aligned with the red disc in a way that the teeth from the blue disc, like this one here, is in the middle of the teeth from the red disc. Now, this is a very simple method, and with this method we can construct a very complicated magnet. This magnet has double the number of the teeth that each disc has, and moreover the pattern of the pole of this magnet goes like south north, south north, south north, etc. That would be impossible to make with a simple magnet, but with this way this is possible. So the rotor is almost ready, and I will finally attach the ball bearings on the shaft. So this is the first ball bearing and this is the second ball bearing. The rotor is now 100% complete. There is of course no commutator because the rotor does not carry the coils, and this means that the stepper motors have a longer lifetime from normal DC brushed motors. Now, it's time to make the stator of the motor.